Forces again into action, and no matter what stance the Greek citizen stands for this referendum, the stance could surely be active, and in this time of action and a very dense political time, it would be a crime against the history for a group to stand absent no matter the political stance. An interpretation of the political action or a political dense moment could not be that of a philosopher. An interpretation is also something is interpreted also through action. So the real question is which action should we follow to interpret the referendum and the stance to it as we want to. On our behalf, we see clearly that people who are going to vote for yes in the referendum stand on a very feared middle class, maybe small bosses or bigger bosses that try to secure their relation with the European capital and the states, of course. And a stance to no is a very ambivalent stance. If we manage to create platforms and structures of self-organization and struggle, maybe we can take this stream of no and make it into a productive stream of self-organization and emancipation from capital and state. A big percentage of the people that is going to vote for no are people that come from the struggles, have struggled really hard in these years of crisis, and if we implicate them in a revolutionary process through self-organized structures, I think that the no could be a historical opportunity for the Greek movement. Initiatives that are taken now are not unified. The no bloc, let's say, is no bloc at all. There is no unification of the struggle. For example, we have governmental campaigns that put their efforts into just adding a negotiating argument to the efforts of the governmental elite. Our political role in this situation is to break the doors of negotiation and take the negotiation to the public and create a third player who's going to stand on the table. And we have also the ambition that this player, who's going to be a society that wants to be self-organized and self-constituted,